Good morning, good morning. I hope you all are doing well. I just wanted to come in and talk to you guys real quick. It is the morning time, so forgive me if I look a little rough. dropped the kids off to school. I have a couple of minutes before I start a client, but I just wanted to share something with you guys. So I had recently joined a women's group. Well, at least that's what I thought it was. I had joined a women's group, and it was very encouraging for me because at that time, I just needed the encouragement, you know what I mean? A little bit more encouragement. I already had my personal relationship with God, you know what I'm saying? I have for a very long time since I was young. And so, you know, I just wanted to join a group of women, you know, where we could pray for each other, minister to each other, and stuff like that. So later on, I realized that it became a church. And I kind of like was thrown off because that's kind of not like what I signed up for. And so I continued on with it, but, you know, I just waited to use, you know, to hear from God and my discernment. I didn't want to be dealing with feelings because, you know, feelings are fickle. And as a woman, you know, your feelings can go up and down. Long story short, I started feeling a spirit of religion cling to me. I started feeling a spirit of confusion. I started feeling not like myself. And I kind of like forgot who I was, almost like I forgot who I was in Christ. And it was crazy because it was like, I joined the group and, you know, first we were ministering to each other and, you know, we were sharing, you know, because iron sharpens iron. So we were sharing testimonies and we were praying for each other and lifting up each other and edifying each other. And then, you know, the head prophetess of the group, recently got ordained as pastor, and it didn't sit right with me because I always wanted to be a part of the church where the order was almost like a marriage, like the man is the head, then you have the woman or whatever, because that is the correct order. And that's what I'm being used to. So I kind of noticed like I was dealing with a spirit of religion that was trying to cling to me, and God had delivered me from that years ago. But I started finding myself kind of like being dumbed down, you know what I'm saying? And another thing that didn't sit right with me is that the person who is the prophetess and who got ordained as the pastor, mind you, this is a Zoom internet church. We all live in different places. The person got ordained, and so, you know, as the pastor, it was like, you know, it was hard for somebody close to my age, kind of like to look up to them as like a mother in Christ. That was kind of out of order to me because it was like, nah, like, I don't know. It just wasn't sitting right with my spirit. You know what I mean? So I just wanted to say, you know, beware of the spirit of religion. Definitely have your personal relationship with God so that you can hear from him to know exactly where he wants you to be and what he wants you to do. You know what I'm saying? You definitely have to be careful. You also have to be careful when people think that when you don't subscribe to what they're doing or sign up to their church or be a part of what they're doing, if you kind of slack off, they try to come to you as if, you know, you not being in the group or them not seeing you at whatever they decide to have, that automatically you have backslidden or you have moved away from God. No, you don't. You don't want to allow that because they begin to look at themselves as your connection to God when we know Jesus is the only connection. So be aware of that. Don't allow anyone or anything to dumb you down in the spirit. That's what I feel like God is, you know, was tapping me on the shoulder about, like, hey, you forgetting who you are. You know what I'm saying? Your identity is not in a person. It's not in a church. Your identity is in me. And, you know, being in a group, it should be for you to edify one another and then to go out and to minister and to edify others, you know. But I just didn't feel right because it wasn't making any sense to me because I always believed that you should be in a church that's kind of local to you where you can impact your community. And at the end of the day, we are the church. You understand what I'm saying? So our responsibility is to impact to the community. But then when it becomes a formal thing like a church organization, then you have to beware because there's some other things connected to that. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm just saying use your own discernment, and I'm going with my discernment. It's not to take anything away from them because they're lovely women, you know, woman of God or whatever, but you know, we have to be careful with the spirit of religion. You know what I'm saying? The Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, and the rulers of the darkness of this present world, spiritual wickedness in high places. And the enemy definitely comes, and he surfaces in the church. You understand what I'm saying? He comes, and he definitely sits in the church and looks for vulnerable people. And at that time, I was very vulnerable, because I was going through some things. So I really was vulnerable in the spirit because I needed some edification. I needed to be around sisters that can edify. We can edify one another, and just, you understand what I'm saying? Iron sharpens iron. And then, like I said, it just turned into this church, and we're signing on, and I was cool with the prayer and the Bible study and everything like that. But then Sunday church came, and then, you know, you're getting assigned to do this, you're getting assigned to do that. And so you're looking at this one person, and they're the head, and they're the pastor of this internet church, and they are hours away from me. And you have some that are, you know, in Houston, some that are in New York and everything like that. And I'm all for fellowship, you know what I'm saying? But I never really wanted to join a church, per se. That's not what I was looking to do, especially on the internet, you know what I'm saying? Zoom. Not to say that there's anything wrong with it, but I don't feel like that was where I was led to be a part of this thing. It kind of like snuck into me. I feel like the whole church thing kind of like was snuck in. You know what I mean? Not to say that they purposely did it, but I felt like that's where I was with it. If I missed something, then that's on me. But what I will say is that I thank God for his mercy, his grace. I thank him for his spirit. I thank him for tapping me on the shoulder and showing me what I need to see. But what I really had to do, the reason why I really had to pull away, because I felt like I was being dumbed down in the spirit. And that's not what God wanted for me. I've been tracking with God too long. I have too much of history with God to let anyone or anything dumb me down in the spirit because they want to edify themselves in the ministry. No. So you have to be very, very, very careful. With that said, I pray that you guys have a blessed day. Stay woke in your personal relationship with God, and don't allow anyone or anything to dumb you down in the spirit.